الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له رب العالمين وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله المبعوث بالكتاب المبين أنزله لنقرأه تدبرا ونتأمله تبصرا ونسعد به تذكرا فهو كتابه الدال عليه وطريقه الموصلة إليه ونوره الذي أشرقت له الظلمات ورحمته المهداة التي بها صلاح جميع المخلوقات وهو السبب الواصل بينه وبين عباده إذا انقطعت الأسباب وهو بابه الأعظم الذي منه الدخول فلا يغلق إذا غلقت الأبواب وهو النزل الكريم الذي لا تشبع منه العلماء هو نور البصائر من عماها هو شفاء الصدور هو نور القلوب هو لذة النفوس هو حادي الأرواح إلى بلاد الأفراح هو المنادي في المساء وفي الصباح يا أهل الفلاح حي على الفلاح أما بعد فأوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله قال تعالى يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. Dear brothers and sisters, Surah Al-Ahzab retells the story of the Prophet's wives, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa radiyallahu anhun, as they reportedly asked for more ornaments, mata' al-hayat al-dunya. In response, the man of praise, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was told to offer them the option of divorce or remaining married to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The verses in Surah Al-Ahzab read, Ya ayyuhan nabi, qul li azwajik, in kuntunna turidna al-hayata al-dunya wa zinataha, fata'alayn, umatti'kunna wa usarrihkunna sarahan jameela, wa in kuntunna turidna allaha wa rasoolahu wa addara al-akhira, fa inna allaha a'adda lil muhsinati minkunna ajran azeema. O Prophet, say to your wives, if your desire is for this present life and its finery, then come. I will make provision for you and I will release you with kindness. But if you desire Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His Prophet, and the final home, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared great rewards for those of you who do good, lil muhsinat. The Prophet's wives, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, chose to remain with the Prophet. In doing so, they chose Allah, they chose the Almighty. And this is the topic of today's khutbah, choosing God. We will see, inshallah, how the Quran focuses our attention on this major theme by presenting it in different and sometimes subtle ways. Khalilullah Ibrahim alayhi salam exemplifies this condition profoundly. Surah Maryam tells us that Ibrahim alayhi salam withdrew from his family, from his people and the idols they were praying to. وَأَعْتَزِلُكُمْ وَمَا تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. But this sacrifice, this withdrawal was not lost on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَمَّا اَعْتَزَلَهُمْ وَمَا يَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ وَهَبْنَا لَهُ إِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبُ. When he left them and when he left those idols, we granted him Ishaq and Yaqub. Not only that, وَكُلًّا جَعَلْنَا نَبِيًّا. We made them both prophets. Choosing Allah, brothers and sisters, is not an escape from the world, but an engagement with the world. It does not anesthetize us to the pains and apparent injustices of life. It invites us to confront our fragility with honesty and compassion. And it asks us to play our role in constructing relationships and communities. Yes, Ibrahim alayhi salam withdrew, wa'atazilukum, he withdrew from his people, but Ibrahim alayhi salam set a new chapter in the religious history of mankind. Ibrahim alayhi salam is a father of all those who set on a journey to an unknown destination, armed only with the yaqeen, the unwavering faith and trust in Allah's good decree. Ibrahim alayhi salam says, Inni muhajirun ila rabbi, I will flee to my Lord. Surah Safat, wa qala inni dhahibun ila rabbi, I will go to my Lord. Sayahdeen, surely he will guide me. But choosing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not always an easy path. Ibrahim alayhi salam was tested with the prospect of the death of his son. إِنَّ هَذَا لَهُوَ الْبَلَاءُ الْمُبِينُ. Truly, this is the manifest trial. Musa alayhi salam says in Surah Al-Shu'ara, وَيَضِيقُ صَدْرِي وَلَا يَنْطَلِقُ لِسَانِي. I am distressed, or I will be distressed, and my tongue is tied, and my tongue will be tied. The blessed Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was rejected and stoned by his very own people. He suffered unimaginably to teach us that suffering is an opportunity to wait at the doors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Three times the Quran consoles the man of praise sallallahu alayhi wasallam with the exact same words. In Surah Al-Hijr, وَلَا تَحْزَنْ عَلَيْهِمْ. In Surah Al-Nahl, وَلَا تَحْزَنْ عَلَيْهِمْ. In Surah Al-Naml, وَلَا تَحْزَنْ عَلَيْهِمْ. Do not grieve over them. But it is sunnatullah azza wa jal that winter ends with spring. إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. With hardship comes ease. Or as the book of Psalms puts it, those who sow in tears shall reap shouts of joy. There is much contemporary relevance to these narratives, to the qasas of the Quran, because the Quran does not narrate stories simply because they happened. The Quran tells us what happened only when events that happened then have a bearing on what we can do now. Choosing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us freedom, because we know that we will have the upper hand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Musa alayhi salam, لا تخف, do not be afraid, إنك أنت الأعلى, you have the upper hand. In the same surah, Pharaoh threatens the sorcerers, the sahara, with severe punishment because they submitted to Allah, but they chose Allah, and their response is documented in the Quran. قالوا لن نؤثرك على ما جاءنا من البينات والذي فطرنا فاقض ما أنت قاض إنما تقضي هذه الحياة الدنيا إنا آمنا بربنا ليغفر لنا خطايانا وما أكرهتنا عليه من السحر والله خير وأبقى. They said, we shall never prefer you to the manifest signs that have come to us, nor to he who created us. So decide whatever you will. You can only decide matters of this life. We believe in our Lord, hoping that he will forgive us our sins, and that he will forgive us the sorcery that you forced us to practice. Wallahu khayrun wa abqa. God is better and more lasting. The sorcerers were more than just role models. They had the strength to stand apart, to refuse and to say no. And notice here the use of the words وَمَا أَكْرَهْتَنَا عَلَيْهِ مِنَ السِّحْرِ, and the sorcery that you forced us to practice. They were forced to practice as-sihr, but when they chose Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they were able to liberate themselves from the shackles of that forced labor. وَاللَّهُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى. God is better and more lasting. That is the stunning truth at which they finally arrived. Those sorcerers, the sahara, they truly understood what was later revealed as Quran in Surah Ali Imran, إِنَّ الْأَمْرَ كُلَّهُ لِلَّهِ. In Surah Al-A'raf, لَا أَمْلِكُ لِنَفْسِي نَفْعًا وَلَا ضَرًّا إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ. In Surah Al-Tawbah, لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا. In Surah Al-Talaq, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. And so on, all those verses on yaqeen, on tawakkul. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open our eyes to His radiance. يهدي الله لنوره من يشاء. Our hearts to His transforming love. يحبهم. May He give us the power and the trust to face truth. إِنَّا سَنُلْقِي عَلَيْكَ قَوْلًا ثَقِيلًا. May He give us the hope that our hardships are not the last word about what is possible. وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. And may He bless us with the full-hearted will for the well-being of the entire world. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. أما بعد, فأوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Dear brothers and sisters, to choose Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to recognize who and what we truly are. When we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we can take away the veils. We can put aside our masks. There is no fear of rejection. There is no fear of misinterpretation. Like what happened to Maryam alayha salam, لَقَدْ جِئْتِ شَيْئًا فَرِيَّا. You have done something terrible. With Allah, that is not the case. The Quran tells us that we are the ones whose thoughts are known to Allah. We are not what others perceive us to be. We are what Allah knows us to be. إِنَّا نَعْلَمُ مَا يُسِرُّونَ وَمَا يُعْلِنُونَ. We know what they reveal and what they conceal. The man of praise sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in a hadith which you all know very well, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَى صُوَرِكُمْ وَأَمْوَالِكُمْ وَإِنَّمَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَى قُلُوبِكُمْ وَأَعْمَالِكُمْ. Allah does not look at your appearances. He does not look at what you have. He does not look at your wealth. He looks at your hearts and your deeds. The Quran sums it. إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. In the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most honored of you are the ones most mindful of Him, جَلَّ جَلَالُهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listens to those who otherwise go unnoticed, وَالْمُسْتَضْعَفِينَ مِنَ الرِّجَالِ وَالنِّسَاءِ. Even if we cannot explain every instance of human suffering, and although Allah's wisdom can sometimes be beyond our imagination, it is comforting to know that when we choose Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our words are heard, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listens. وَاللَّهُ يَسْمَعُ تَحَاوُرَكُمَا. The implication is that when we choose Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we must make sure not only to look but to listen and understand. For appearances deceive and clothes betray. فَعَرَفَهُمْ وَهُمْ لَهُمْ مُنْكِرُونَ. Maybe, وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ, this is one reason why the Qur'an seems to favor sound over sight, seems to be favoring the faculty of listening over vision. فَاسْتَمِعُوا, as Ernest MacLean writes in his book, Meditations Through the Qur'an, he says, sound is our greatest key to interiority. Truth is known via the ear. Primordial religious truth has always been discovered by the ear. In the context of the Quran, the ear is the most important organ. Hearing is Allah's own avenue, is, in his words, is God's own avenue of understanding. What a simple truth, and how beautifully it is conveyed by the Quran, and how deeply, in an age of outward appearances, the world needs to hear it today. Dear brothers and sisters, I opened this khutbah with the Quranic account of the Prophet's wives, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, radiyallahu anhunna, in Surah Al-Ahzab. In as much as the Prophet's wives chose to remain with him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the following verses reminded them that the privilege pertaining to their status carries with it responsibility. And the Quran expresses it very beautifully. يا نساء النبي لستن كأحد من النساء. And that, for the Quran, is enough. You are like no other woman. Indeed, the ideals of the Quran are very high, but that is our vocation. It remains a privilege to carry the Quran. And what a privilege it is. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإنه لذكر لك ولقومك وسوف تسألون. And it is a reminder for you and your people, and you will all be questioned. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما. اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا. اللهم حبب إلينا القرآن وزينه في قلوبنا. اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن العالمين به والعاملين به. اللهم احفظ المسلمين والمسلمات في كل مكان. اللهم وفق المسلمين والمسلمات في كل مكان. اللهم احفظ هذه المدينة, مدينة كامبريدج, وسائر بلاد العالمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.